Welcome to this software testing tutorial on bug report and bug reporting in software testing. I will show you how to write bug report in manual testing automatically using a tool. I will also explain bug reporting in Jira. First, what is a bug report? You should know how to write bug report in software testing if you are a tester, developer or product owner. A bug report or defect report is needed to report or document a bug. Examples of bugs are that a requirement is not implemented in the system, or not implemented correctly, or not implemented completely, or there is some unexpected system behavior. A bug report is the information needed by the developer to understand that bug and reproduce it, so that he can fix it. There should be one bug report per bug with all the problems mentioned in that single bug report. Next, bug reporting in software testing. The bug report template or bug reporting format means which information is needed in your bug report. The bug report template or defect report template is according to your project's needs. But the common information needed is project name, issue type, for example, bug or enhancement, summary, attachment, or bug report zip file, and description with steps and actual result with the problem, severity, priority, etc. Out of these, in the bug report, summary, which is a short description, and the screenshots and the description itself with the steps and the actual problem are the most important. When you take bug report, the bug reporting system will have a form with all of these fields. This is the Atlassian website that make the Jira software. Now, bug reporting in Jira, you can create a bug report in Jira with the create issue button. That will take you to the create issue form, and in the create issue form you can give the project, and these are the mandatory fields here. You can select what is the issue type. Issue type can be story, task or bug, and you have to give the summary, attachment and description, etc. How to write bug reports in bug reporting in manual testing? First of all, you should give all the steps in the description, in brief. Then give a short summary. You can get the summary from the last actual result, which is different from the expected result. Give the screenshots in the attachment field and other information according to your project's bug report template. Next, if you don't already have a test case that would catch this bug, you should write a test case for it also. Also, an automation testing script to catch this bug from the next execution onward. You can get these things by using the TestCase Studio plugin. Now, TestCase Studio records user actions in the browser. It is a web browser recorder plugin and screenshot plugin. This means that it can write bug reports as a bug finder helper in web applications only. TestCase Studio is free. You can use it for automatically writing your bug report. You still have to copy and paste your bug report in your bug reporting tool like Jira. First, let me show you TestCase Studio install. You can go to the selectorshub.com website, and I'll put the link of the TestCase Studio in the description also, and go to products, then click on TestCase Studio. Now here it describes TestCase Studio, that you can add TestCase Studio to your browser from the below links, etc., and then pin the extension, and whenever you want the recording to start, you can click on the TestCase Studio logo. So I'm going to install it for the Chrome browser by clicking on the install button. That link redirected me to the Chrome Web Store. Now here I'll click add to Chrome, and then click on add extension. It says TestCase Studio has been added to Chrome, and it opens Selectors Hub YouTube channel. Let me close it for now. And if I click on this extensions icon in the toolbar, I can see TestCase Studio. Now I can pin it here. Next, I need to restart the browser. So let me restart Chrome and come back. I've restarted the Chrome browser, and this is the selectorshub.com practice page where you can practice your automation testing, etc. Now let me show you a bug report example. So here there is a form with user email, password, company, mobile phone number, etc. So let us say that I am testing. Now before I start testing, I have to click on this TestCase Studio. So I just click over here. Here is the user interface of TestCase Studio. I can set the TestCase name here. So let me call it user entry. When I download the bug report, it is going to name the file as user entry. Now here there are some configuration controls, and the columns are, it gives the step numbers. Then here there will be the actual steps. The test data that is used will be here. And here I can put the expected result or the actual result. Then it also gives XPath and CSS selector and also screenshots. So for now, let us say that I don't want XPath and CSS selector with the technical details of those steps. So I can customize them by clicking on this button, click to add or remove columns. So I can uncheck XPath. Now XPath is, column is gone, CSS selector is gone. And now the recording is started. So as soon as I go to the form, it is going to record the steps. So let me enter my email. Then I'm going to enter a password. Then enter my company. And then click on the submit button. Now the form has been submitted. It is posting the form. But there is no confirmation message here. So let me go to TestCase Studio. And here I can click to stop the recording. Now here I can see that it has recorded the step numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the steps are open website. And in test data, it has given the URL. Then step number 2 is enter the email address into enter email. The test data is also here. Enter, it has masked the password. Then enter software and testing training into the company field. Click on submit and scroll down. So this scroll down is an extra step. So this I don't need. I can delete the step from here. I can just copy all the steps. And in fact, here I'm going to put expected result also. So here I'm expecting that email address is validated. Then it should validate the password that I have set up for that email address. Then I'm expecting a confirmation message. Now I can see the screenshots here also, or I can download it. So let me click on this where it says test case. When I download it, it will take the name that I have specified in TestCase Studio. I can click on save here. Screenshots also, I'll download in the same folder. Now this has been downloaded, and this is a CSV file, which means I can open it in Excel, and I can also open it in Notepad. So here we see it has step, data, expected result, etc. Now if I don't want the data, I can remove that column from there. So I don't want data, and I don't want screenshots. And now download the test case. Now when I open this file, it is giving me step and expected result. So in the bug report, first of all, I need to put a summary. So I can remove this and put the summary where I gave this email address is validated, password is validated, and confirmation message. So I can say here the actual result is the opposite of the expected result. Email address is not validated. Whether I have an account with selectorshub.com, then password is not validated and confirmation message is missing. Then this last actual result I can combine and put it in the summary only. Email address not validated, password not validated, and missing confirmation message. I can produce a short summary from the steps only. And the screenshots are also there. The screenshots are numbered. Open website. This is the second step, third step, fourth step, like that. And I can simply attach the zip file as the attachment. So here the test data is also shown. Now here in my bug report, after the last step, I should mention that this is the expected result. Now I can take the summary, I can take the screenshots zip file as attachment, and I can take this, all these steps, and put it in the description in my bug tracking tool. Now let me show you one other thing in TestCase Studio, how to convert this bug report into a test automation script. Now I can go to TestCase Studio. Now in TestCase Studio, I have these columns enabled: data, expected results, XPath. So let me include XPath also. And here I can copy all the XPaths and I can use them here, and I can use them in my test automation script. But TestCase Studio provides another feature. So I can set the driver command here, and if I select this, I can specify whatever driver command I want to use in my test automation script. There is the XPath value keyword. So TestCase Studio will replace this XPath value keyword with the actual XPath. Now after setting the driver command, I can copy all the commands from here and I can paste them in my test automation script. So this is some code that I've already written to navigate to the website, etc. And here I can paste this partial test automation code. Now let me pause the video and complete this code, then I will just show it to you. So I just gave dot send keys because the web element was already identified by the TestCase Studio. So I gave my email address. In the password field, I also gave the send keys selenium command. And this is not my real password actually. In the company field, I gave send keys software and testing training and clicked on submit. Now I didn't have to figure out the locators for all these elements on the web page. Now what I can do is I can run this. The only thing remaining is that when the bug is fixed, I need to add an assertion for the confirmation message. Now let me run it. So Selenium WebDriver has opened the Chrome browser and it is navigating to that web page, and here you will see that it is going to execute the commands that I have given in my Selenium WebDriver script. So in this bug reporting in TestCase Studio tutorial, I explained how to write bug report in manual testing and how to use TestCase Studio to write a sample bug report automatically. Please subscribe to my software and testing training channel. Thank you.